Welcome back to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the Executive Chairman over at Westwater Resources, Terence Cryan. Terence, it's so great to see you again.
Good to see you, Natalie. Good morning.
Now, we have some big news. The company has just released new financial and operational updates. What are the key takeaways there?
So we were very pleased to announce yesterday that we have optimized phase one of our Kellyton Graphite Processing Plant, which has been under construction in Kellyton, Alabama for just over a year. That optimization will increase our phase one throughput by more than 100%. And it's really a response to increased market and customer demand. You may recall that there are 14 battery gigaplants currently announced or under construction in the United States. All of those plants will need graphite anode material for their lithium ion batteries. And so really in a reaction to that, we made the decision to increase the throughput of phase one. Now, making that decision was certainly easier for us based on the improved economics that come with that decision. So by increasing the throughput to 7,500 metric tons of anode material, we've increased the net present value of phase one by more than three times. And we've increased the pre-tax IRR from 15% to nearly 25%.
And Terence, we've even chatted about how the demand in the industry has been evolving in previous conversations, but it's almost as if it's shaping the Kellyton project, in your experience, to have even more potential in the coming phases. Like, we're just talking about phase one. What can we expect to see in the timeline for Kellyton to be able to be up and running just based on the demand that we're seeing right now for battery grade materials?
So that is certainly true. And we are on track to begin commissioning phase one at Kellyton later this year in the fourth quarter. We also announced yesterday that we're intending to increase the throughput and capacity of phase two. Now, phase two is still at a pre-feasibility level, and we would anticipate beginning the definitive feasibility study for phase two later this year. But it's our intention to increase the capacity so that on an overall basis, phase one and phase two, we would have more than 40,000 metric tons of anode material at Kellyton. And that's really, again, a direct response to what we're seeing in terms of, you know, market and customer demand for our material, given that, you know, currently in the United States, you know, we're 100% dependent on imported anode material for lithium ion batteries.
And Terence, speaking of Kellyton, it seems like there's also a new debt finance financing sheet that will be able to cover the optimization. What are the details there as well?
Yes, thanks, Natalie. We were also able to announce yesterday that we have signed a term sheet for $150 million debt financing that will cover the balance of the capital required to complete phase one. So definitely a significant step on our part in that area. And I think investors were, you know, looking for some confirmation that we have the capital needed to complete phase one. And obviously we need to work through that process of, you know, due diligence and documentation to get that financing completed. But we're hoping to have that finished in the second quarter.
Well, Terence, it sounds like the beginning of some more major updates to come. Thank you so much for stopping by and sharing this with us.
Thank you, Natalie.
Again, the Executive Chairman at Westwater Resources, Terence Cryan.